Hello everyone, in this video I'll explain you about design of column splice. So splice is nothing but, I'll show you. Have you seen this? So this is one column and this is another column. Okay, for example, if this is our roof and this is our floor, and distance between the roof and floor is suppose 10 meters, but we are having 5 meters column. That means the length of this column is 5 meters and this one is 5 meters, and by using this plate, this is called splice plate, by using this splice plate we are going to withstand these two columns like this. Okay, this is the bolted connection, bolted or welding we are going to use to connect these splice plate to withstand these two columns. Okay, that is the purpose of splice plate. So I'll explain you the sort of example problem, how to design the splice plate. So this is the question. ISHB 300 at 680 Newton per meter as column section was given. To be spliced, the design loads are axial load over the column is 300 kilonewtons, shear force 75 and bending moment 20 kilonewtons. So by using butt weld, we need to connect the column section. Sorry, design the column section. So first, we need to assume that column ends to be machined, that is nothing but 50% of the load is transferred directly and 50% by fasteners. So fasteners or weldings or whatever. So we need to assume like this. After assuming this, splicing is done both the flanges. Nothing but this is the flange portion. Have you seen this? This is I section beam, I section column. So this is flange portion and this is web portion. Okay, if suppose I draw like this. Okay, this is the web portion, this is the flange portion, like that. This is the web portion and this is the flange portion. We are connected the splice plate to the flange portion. So for that, direct load on splice, that is 50% we need to transfer. So that is 300 by 2, 300 by 2 nothing but axial load over the column is 300, so by 2 into 50%, that is nothing but 0.5. so I got 75 kilonewtons. So like that, load on splice, load on splice due to moment. So due to moment, the load on splice is nothing but 20 into 10 power 6. Nothing but here, bending moment he given that 20. So divided by 300 plus 6. So this 300 is overall load and 6 is nothing but a thickness of that splice plate. Okay, like that we are going to do this load on splice due to moment. So after that, total we need to, total design load. Total design load is nothing but we got 75 and moment 65. So I got 140.36. next, width of the splice plate, that is equal to nothing but, so here the width of the splice plate is nothing but flange width, because we attached this splice plate to the flange, I section flange. So flange width is nothing but a splice plate width of that flange. So that is 250 mm. This is available in code book. Next one is thickness of the splice plate required. We need to find out the thickness of the splice plate required. That is 140.36 into 10 power 4 by 250 into 150. 150 is nothing but half of the load. 250 is nothing but that's yield stress. So we got this value. That is, I took it as 6 mm thickness of the splice plate. So provide 250 by 6 mm splice plate. So after providing the splice plate, we need to connect by using welding or bolting. Here I choose welding. So nothing but here we are doing the butt joint. Why? Because butt joint is nothing but, if suppose one plate is like this and one plate is like this, so side by side we are doing this welding here. So like that, the column is like this and another column is like this. Here we are going to do welding. Okay, that's why we are doing this. So here let us provide a single V butt weld. The code is specifying that while doing the throat thickness for butt weld or welding, 5 by 8 times the thickness of the flange. So this value is available in steel tables book, that is 6.625 mm. The next one is, I'm going to write the relevant properties of this section which are given in question. So these are all the properties of this section which is available in SP6 book, steel tables book. Next one is total design load for flange splice. Already we got the value. So required length of that weld, nothing but This total load divided by 6.625 into 150. Already we got this value, effective throat thickness. Okay, I got 141.24 mm, which is less than 250 mm. And next one is, hence provide single V butt weld for splicing the column sections. Okay, here previously we provided single V butt weld, so like that, for weld spacing of the column sections. For the shear force, already we got the shear force, that is 75, provided double V butt weld on web. Okay, so next, and that is nothing but effective throat thickness for the web. So web portion is, thickness of the web is nothing but 9.4 mm. And next one is capacity of the weld. So while calculating the capacity of the weld, that is nothing but effective throat thickness or thickness of the web into 100. This 100 is nothing but 0.4 times the yield stress. The code is specifying we need to take this 0.4 times the yield stress, that is 100. So I got 940 Newton per mm. And required length of the weld we need to calculate. That is, here we are calculating for shear stress. The shear stress is 75 into 10 power 3 divided by this capacity of the weld. I got 79.78 mm. After that, available length of the welding. So available length of the welding is nothing but 300 minus 2 into 25.1. This 25.1 is the relevant properties for this ISHV 300. That is H2 value. Okay, and this 300 is the depth of this section that is mentioned in question. That is ISHB 300. Okay, that is nothing but depth of the section. So we are detecting that height value, that is H2 value. So two flanges are there. So 2 into 25.1. I got 249.8 mm, whichever is greater than 79.78 mm. Hence, it is okay. So like that, we are going to do these connections by using welding. So this is the splice plate problem. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching.